Thank you, Mr. Speaker, and I would like to add my condolences to the Mallon family, particularly to Orla, to his son-in-law Mark, to his granddaughter Lara, and to the wider family circle. I also want to extend sympathies to his friends and colleagues in the SDLP. As a role model for generous leadership, you can have no better. Whilst those closest to him will feel his passing most acutely, all of us in politics, indeed all of us in Northern Ireland, are the richer for his life and the poorer for his passing. He was a man for whom fairness and integrity were not just political ambitions, but were part of his DNA. His commitment to non-violence, to civil rights, were unwavering and uncompromising. I never had the privilege of serving here with him in this chamber. He retired the year that I was elected. But I did have the pleasure in recent years of sharing platforms with him on various occasions. And he had lost none of his wisdom or wit, which made him such a formidable politician and such an admirable man. While I never served here with him, I owe it to him and other courageous leaders like him that I've had the opportunity to do so, and to live the second half of my life in considerably more peaceful times than the first half. For that, I, and I believe all of us, owe him personally an enormous debt of gratitude. Our best and most fitting tribute to him is to work together to deliver on the promise of 1998 and the Good Friday Agreement, which was his gift to us. Thank you.